हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। माय नेम इज़ विजय कुमार, फैकल्टी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, तेलंगाना ट्राइबल वेलफेयर रेजिडेंशियल डिग्री कॉलेज, करीमनगर। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट 1986, विच इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ बिजनेस लॉ। इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट who is consumer, what is consumer protection act actually, what are the benefits to the consumers. Let us discuss in this session. So consumer protection act 1986, so in this we are going to see the introduction and what who are the consumers and what exactly the Consumer Protection Act, how it affects. Okay, in this session we are going to learn the outcomes of the session is introduction to Consumer Protection Act. Next, objectives of Consumer Protection Act, rights of consumer, redressal agencies and councils, consumer protection councils. Next, case studies. Okay, so before knowing Consumer Protection Act, we need to learn about actually what is law. Law means a set of rules and regulations which are imposed by authority and the public to be followed, which means law is set of rules and regulations which is imposed by the higher authority and the people for the smooth running of the country, state or whatever, smooth running of life. Okay, law means a rule made by the authority for the proper regulation of a community or society for correct conduct in life. Okay, set of rules and regulations. So rules are regulations which means which makes our happy life. Okay, which doesn't give negative effect to another person. Those are called rules and regulations. Okay, law is different and act is different. It is an act of parliament with statute, commonly called a law, enacted as primary legislation by a national or sub-national parliament. It sets out the main objectives which the legislation intended to achieve, which means which is intended to achieve, that is called. For example, Contract Act, Indian Contract Act 1872, Consumer Protection Act 1986 and Indian Companies Act 1956, Indian Partnership Act 1932. These are the examples of acts. Okay, here the understanding of law means set of rules and regulations which are imposed by the higher authority or government on the public. Okay, the public should be followed the rules and regulations. Okay, so what is consumer? We need to find who is consumer. Okay, consumer refers to many individuals or households that use goods and services generated within the economy. Okay, consumer are nothing but a buyer who bought goods and services from the trader for the consideration, for price paying. Okay, without consideration it is not called as a buying. Okay, and the consumer is defined as someone who acquired goods or services for the direct use of ownership rather than for resale or use in production and manufacturing. here we need to know one thing: what are the goods and what are the services? Goods are nothing but any property which is movable from one place to another place, that is called a goods. Those are called goods. And growing crop also consider as a goods. And future related properties, those are all called future goods. Okay, for example, when your father buys apple for you and you consume it, your father as well as yourself are treated as consumer. The same thing applies to hiring taxi to get your school. Okay, here consumer is nothing but any person who bought goods and services from the trader for the particular consideration, then it is called consumer. That person is called consumer. Services are not services. What are the services? The government has given a vast definition to the services. Services are nothing but banking services, financial services, transportation services, doctor services, and lawyer services. So there are different kind of services which are human beings are going to get from the particular persons. Okay, services are different, goods are different, but a person is going to avail services or going to purchase goods for the particular consideration, then that is called a consumer. Okay, so concept of consumer protection. So what is the concept of consumer protection means? It's a safeguarding the interest and rights of the consumer. The main intention, the main objective, the main concept of the Consumer Protection Act is to protect the consumers of goods and services from unfair trading, unfair trades of the traders, which means this act will protect, safeguarding the consumers from the fraud, from the unfair trade practices. Unfair trade practices means the trader will give discussion is something, the delivery of goods are something, the price which is mentioned on the product is different, and the trader is selling price is different on a product. Okay, services are different, the providing services are different. So when a consumer will become a victim, then the consumer is supposed to get the compensation. Okay, so this is a main objective, this is a main intention of Consumer Protection Act. In other words, it refers to the measures adopted for the protection of consumers from unscrupulous and unethical malpractices, which means traders are committing frauds when they are selling the products, when they are providing the services to the consumers. So to protect by these kind of frauds from the trader, so the Consumer Protection Act has been enacted in the year of 1986. And the business to provide them speedy redressal of their grievances. Okay, consumer has been cheated from a particular trader. Then what he has to do? What the aggrieved party has to do? He actually has to get the compensation for the what he has lost, what he has cheated from trader. So to provide them speedy redressal agent, speedy redressal means complaints. They are getting, if a person If a consumer is cheated, then he has to go to redressal agencies. The redressal agencies will give a proper compensation judgment to a aggrieved party. Okay, grievances. Grievances are nothing but like what he is facing. What kind of product, on what kind of product he, that aggrieved party cheated. Okay, so let us see the Consumer Protection Act. Consumer Protection Act 1986 was enacted for the better protection of the interest of consumers. The provisions of the Act came into force with effect from 15/4/1987. The Act was enacted in the year of 1986. The provisions are came into force in the year of 1987. Consumer Protection Act imposes strict liability on a manufacturer. Strict liability on a manufacturer. If there any fraud occurs, that is a responsible, that is a liability of the manufacturer. In case of supply of defective goods by him, when manufacturer supplied a defective goods, a damaged goods, okay, expired goods to the consumer, that whole liability goes to the manufacturer only. And the service provider, whoever provides the services which is having not quality, which is not related to the consumer, then the service provider also responsible, and he is also having liability in case of deficiency in rendering of its services. Whether the service provider is unable to render a quality services, then the service provider will become a responsible person. Okay, next, history of Consumer Protection Act. So what is the history? What is the history behind Consumer Protection Act? The Act was passed in Lok Sabha on 9th December 1986, and it came into force from 1st July 1987. Rajya Sabha passed on 10th December 1986 and assented by the President of India on 24th December. So 1986, and was published in the Gazette of India on 26th December 1986. Okay, this is the history of Consumer Protection Act, and we are celebrating Consumer Protection Act Day also, Consumer Protection Day also. Okay, so these are the features of Consumer Protection Act. Okay, Consumer Protection Act features, the first one is it applies to all goods and services and unfair trade practices. I told you what is unfair trade practices, the trading which misleads the consumers. Okay, that is called unfair trade practices, malpractices, and cheating, intentionally cheating, and not providing quality services, not providing quality products. Okay, these are all comes under unfair trade practices, unless especially exempted by the central government. If any goods and services which are exempted by the central government, those are not comes under Consumer Protection Act. Okay, it covers all sectors, whether private, public, or cooperative. So Consumer Protection Act will cover three sectors, and all sectors, that private sector, private, the most probably in the private sector, traders are committed to fraud mostly. Whenever an uneducated customer going to the shop, they misrepresent the product, and they are trying to cheat the customer. So to protect these kind of people, these kind of consumers from the trader, this Act, Consumer Protection Act, has been enacted. Okay, in the public sector, there is a chance there, and it may also have frauding government sector and cooperative societies. Okay, so these all sectors are comes into Consumer Protection Act. Okay, and the third one is it provides for establishment of consumer protection councils. These are very important. Consumer protection councils are very important. We are going to discuss in the further. At the central, state, and district levels to promote and protect the rights of the consumer, and a three-tier quasi-judicial machinery to deal with the consumer grievances and disputes. Okay, here we need to remember three types of consumer protection councils. What are those? District level, state level, and central level. In the same way, there are consumer dispute redressal agencies are there. They are also three-tier. First one is National Commission, second one is State Commission, third one is District Forum. Okay. So Act has been enacted, that is good. Then, what are the objectives why this Act has been came into force? Okay, let's see. To protect the consumer from abuse. To protect the consumer from abuse means to protect the consumer from the unfair practices, from the fraud, from the cheating by the trader. Already I have told you. The main objectives of the Consumer Protection Act to protect the consumers of goods and services from unfair practices by the traders. This is a very and important object. Okay. The second one is to provide a venue for grievance. When they got cheated, where they have to go? How they get compensation on the loss or on fraud? So this Consumer Protection Act established a three-tier redressal agencies, as we have discussed before. First one is National Commission, the second one is State Commission, the third one is District Forum. Okay. The third one is to ensure a better quality of living. To ensure a better quality of living by improving the quality of consumer products and services. So what this Consumer Protection Act will do is they look after the quality of consumer products and services. So these are the main objectives of the Consumer Protection Act. Okay. So then what are the rights of consumer protection, or what are the rights of consumers? Okay. Right to safety, first one. Okay, the second one is right to be informed. Right to be informed. The third one is right to choose. Fourth one, right to be heard. The four fifth one is right to seek redressal. Right to consumer education. Right to basic needs. Right to healthy environment. So these are the rights, main rights of the consumer. Okay, consumer is a god of the business. There is no consumer, there is no business. So that's why rights of the consumer is very, very important. Let us see one by one what are those. Okay, right to be protected, or right to safety. Okay, to be protected against the marketing of goods or the provisions of the services that are hazardous to the health and life. Hazardous means injured. Okay, If there is any product or if there is any marketing goods or services which are affecting negative impact on a consumer, then the consumer has a right to get protected from the particular injured product or services. Okay, the second one is right to be informed. Okay, whenever the consumer is going to purchase a product and he is supposed to be informed the complete description and the details and the price of the particular product, what is going to be bought. Okay, to be protected against dishonest or misleading advertisements or labeling, and the right to be given the facts and information needed to make an informed choice. Okay, whenever the buyer is going to buy the product, he has a right to get the information, to be informed about the particular product. Okay, the third one is right to make choice, to choose the product at competitive prices with an assurance of satisfactory quality. In the marketing, there are different substitute goods are there. Okay, and there are competitive prices among the different products, different companies' product. Here, the consumer has a right to choose the product which is necessary to the consumer, which gives a satisfaction to the consumer is more important. And the quality of the product also will be chosen by the consumer. This is right to choose. The fourth one is right to representation. Right to representation, which means to express consumer interests in the making and execution of government policies. Consumer has a right to express his feelings, express his opinions, express his interests in the making and execution of government policies. Okay. The next one is right to seek redress. Okay, which means to be compensated for the misrepresentation, shoddy goods or unsatisfactory services. We have discussed. When a consumer felt unsatisfaction, a consumer felt he was cheated, then what he has to do? He has to go to the redressal agencies, whether it is National Commission, State Commission or District Forum. And he has to go to the redressal agencies and he has to file a case on the trader or the service provider to get the compensation. So this is a right of the consumer. Okay. Right to consumer education. This is very, very important. Nowadays, many people are not averring of the consumer rights, Consumer Protection Act. Okay. To acquire the knowledge and skills necessary to be an informed to the customer. So whatever the product is available in the market, whatever the product is necessary to the customer or consumer or buyer, so that should be educated by the government or by the consumer protection organizations. Okay. Right to basic needs, which guarantee survival, adequate food, clothing, shelter, healthcare, education, and sanitation. These are the basic needs of the human being. The consumer has a right to get these basic needs, which are very basic and which are mandatory to survive, to mandatory to live the life. Okay? The next one is right to health environment, to live and work in an environment which is neither threatening nor dangerous and which permits a life of dignity and well-being. Human beings are supposed to live and they have to get worked and in a good environment, places which are not having threatening and dangerous, and the people should have dignity and well-being in life. Okay, so these are the rights of consumer. Then what are the consumer responsibilities? They have a right and they are also having a responsibility, right? So these are the responsibilities of consumer. Consumer must exercise his right. Okay, whatever the rights are provided by the Consumer Protection Act, that consumer should exercise, should enjoy the rights. The consumer must select the product according to his preferences. He must file a complaint if he is not satisfied with the quality of product. So here, consumer must possess a willingness and he should have preferences to buy the product. Okay, when the consumer is not satisfied with the product, then he is supposed to complain on a service provider. Okay, next, cautious consumer. The consumer should not blindly believe on the words of seller. We have one doctrine, carry tempter, which means buyer should aware of the product, what is going to buy. Okay, seller will speak many things on a product because he is a seller. He need to sell all products. He need to get the margin on products. So consumer should possess a great knowledge. Consumer should have a minimum knowledge on what kind of products he is going to buy. He must insist on getting full information and quality, quantity, utility, price. Consumer should insist the seller what is price, what is the level of quality, what is the quantity, and what is the price, how to use the product. So this is a responsibility of the consumer. He should ask the service provider or trader. Consumer must be quality conscious, which means consumer himself stops compromising the quality of products while purchasing the goods or services. Consumer must look for the quality marks such as ISI mark, UGG mark, ISO, wool mark, etc. This is very, very important when we are going to buy electrical goods. Electrical goods, if they are not having good quality, it may give negative effect. Okay, that's why whatever the product a consumer is going to buy, he should check with ISI mark. Whether it is agriculture products, he used to check UGG mark and ISO and wool mark. This is very important responsibility of consumers. Insist on cash memo. In our daily life, we may buy many things, but very less people are insist the trader to give cash memo. Cash memo is an evidence to file a complaint. So now onwards, what we are buying, even it is pen, what we are buying, we should get cash memo. Okay, to file a complaint, the consumer needs the evidence of purchase and cash memo. The evidence are proof that consumer has paid for the good or services. How redressal agencies comes to know whether you have paid for something or not, whether you have given consideration or not. So that's why the cash memo, the bill, the receipt is the evidence of the transaction you have made or products you have purchased, services you have avoided. Okay, the last one is filing complaints for the redressal of genuine grievances. Okay, the consumer must file a complaint even for a small loss. This awareness among consumers will make the sellers more conscious to supply quantity of growth. Okay, many people the quality of products are not good for the less price, they may take lives. When consumers are aware, consumers are having good knowledge on filing cases for small products also, small damage also, small losses also, then the trader, the seller will become very conscious and he is supposed to supply a quality of products. Okay, trader committed frauds on consumers. So what are the remedies for the consumers? Okay, so these are the following remedies which are helps to the consumer. Removal of defects from the goods, whatever the products consumer has bought, and there is a remedy. So what are the products has get damaged will be supplied by the trader. Okay, replacement of goods. Okay, if any expired goods sold by the seller to a buyer, when the consumer went to the reversal agencies, and there is a remedy to get the replacement of goods. Okay, refund of price paid means whatever the products get damaged, the seller is supposed to refund the price, how much amount he paid on products. Okay, compensation of loss or injury suffered. So if there is any services provided by the service provider, if any person get damaged or suffered, then the service provider is supposed to pay the compensation of loss. Next, removal of deficiency in services. If there is any deficiency in services, that should be removed by the service provider. Stopping the sale of hazardous goods. Hazardous goods means injurious goods, which means hazardous goods which injured our health, like tobacco, cigarettes, and drugs. These are all hazardous goods which gives negative impact on human being. So this is the introduction, objectives, characteristics, rights, and the responsibilities of consumers. Let us see the three-type redressal agencies. Okay, the aims and objectives of the act are achieved by three-tier system, that is district forum, state commission, and national commission. Okay, district forum, state commission, and national commission. Okay, the first one is district forum. District forum is nothing but this is a one of the first tier in redressal agencies. The district forum shall consist of a person who is or has been or is qualified to be a district judge. The first point is the person is a chairman, the person is a president who is qualified to be a district judge, and two other members, one of them shall be a woman. The first one is the district court judge or equivalent person, the qualified person will be appointed as the president, and two persons will appoint as a member. One among them should be a woman. Okay, one of them should be a woman. And every member of the district forum shall hold office for a term of 5 years. Okay, the term of the member is 5 years or up to the age of 65 years. Okay, did you get my point? When their age more than 65 years, they are supposed to get the retirement. Or when the service has been completed more than 5 years, they are supposed to get superannuation. Okay, they are going to get what you can say, retirement. Okay, it shall have jurisdiction. It shall have jurisdiction to entertain complaints where the value of the goods and services and the compensation, if any, claimed does not exceed 20 lakhs rupees. The district forum will handle the worth of cases, the value of the cases below 20 lakhs. Okay, here the members should possess at least 10 years experience. 10 years experience in economics, law, public administrative, okay, and commerce. And they should possess minimum a degree. Okay, these are the very important points in district forum. So a district forum shall have the powers. What are the powers? Let us say, to remove the defect pointed but the appropriate laboratory from the goods in question. When the case comes to the district forum, the members and judge will send the samples to the laboratory, and if there is any fraud occurred, if there is any misrepresentation occurred, if they have committed any cheating, then to replace the goods with a new goods or similar description which shall be free from any defects. So they ask to replace the goods to the trader. Okay, the third one is to return the complaint the price, or as the case may be, the charges paid by the complainant. Okay, paying the price to the aggrieved party. The fourth one is to pay such amount as may be awarded by its as compensation to the consumer for any loss or injury suffered by the consumer due to the negligence of the opposite party. So compensation should be given to the aggrieved party, the person who lost. That should be the compensation should be given to the consumer by the service provider. Okay, next, state forum or state commission. It consists of a president and two other members. Is the state forum also having one president and two members? The president must be a retired or working judge of high court. Person who wants to become a president of the state forum should have some qualifications, should have some qualities. The president must be a retired or working judge of the high court. It should be nominated by the state government. They are all appointed by the state government. In the year of 1986, it had a jurisdiction to entertain complaints when the value of goods or services exceeds 5 lakh. But now the limit is raised up to 1 crore, which means 20 lakhs to 1 crore. The goods and services limits means between 20 lakhs to 1 crore. Okay, the state commission sends the goods for testing in lab if required. If the upset party is not satisfied, which means when the aggrieved person is not satisfied with the judgment, then they can file an appeal in national commission within the 30 days of the judgment, which is passed by the state commission or state forum. The cost of 3,500 or 50,000 of penalty amount, whichever is less. Okay, here we need to remember, in the state commission, there is a president. The president the president must be a retired or working judge of high court, and there are two members along with the president. One of them should be a woman, and they should possess a minimum degree, and they should have 10 years of experience, and they attach to the commission for the 5 years of career, 65 years of the age. Okay, the limit of the worth case of goods and services are 20,000 to 1 crore, above 20,000, below 1 crore. If the suffered person is not satisfied with the given judgment by the state commission, he is supposed to go to the national commission within the 30 days. Okay, these are the important topics in state forum and state commission, which is established by the state government by giving a notification. Okay, next, national forum or national commission. It consists of a president and four members. When we see district forum is having one president, two members. State commission is having one president, two members. But when we comes to the national commission, there is a one president and four members, and one of whom shall be a woman among three members. Among four members, the woman member should be there. Okay, they are appointed by the central government in the year of 1986. It had jurisdiction to entertain complaints where the value of goods or services exceeds 20 lakhs, but now it exceeds 1 crore. Okay, which the case value, which is compensation value, is having more than 1 crore, the consumer should go to the National Commission to file the case against the trader. Okay, the National Commission sends the goods to the laboratory if it is required. If the aggrieved party is not satisfied, if the suffered person, the upset person, is not satisfied with the judgment, then they can file a complaint in Supreme Court within the 30 days. Supreme Court within the 30 days. Here, the president should be attached to the commission for the 5 years of period. The retirement age of the president is 70 years. Okay, the members' retirement age is 65 years, and their attachment period of the commission is also 5 years. Okay, they should have a minimum degree, and they should possess 10 years of experience in different fields like law, economics, public administration, commerce, and like. Okay, national commission we have discussed. So councils, consumer protection councils, these are also very important to educate the consumers. These are also having three types. Okay, one is central council, state council, and district council. Okay, the district consumer protection council. Okay, it shall consist of the following members. Who are they? They are the collector of the district, by whatever name called, whether it is collector, whether it is the administrator, whether it is a magistrate, additional magistrate, whatever. Okay, and the collector will act as a chairman of the district consumer protection council. Such member are the official and non-official members as may be prescribed by the state government. The members, along with the collector, the rest of the members will be prescribed by the state government. District council shall meet at least twice in a year. They should conduct a meeting twice in a year. Okay, the procedure will be set by the state government. Okay, whatever the procedures are having in district council, will be set up by the state government. Okay. Next, State Consumer Protection Council. It shall consist of the following members. Okay. The minister in charge of consumer affairs in the state government as its chairman. Okay, who is chairman? The person who is minister of consumer affairs, food and civil supplies, will act as a chairman of state consumer protection councils. Okay, the rest of the members, official and non-official, will be suggested, will be prescribed by the state government. The state council shall meet at least twice in a year, and state council also should meet at least twice a year. The procedure will be prescribed by the state government. Next, the Central Consumer Protection Council. It shall consist of the following members, namely the minister, the central minister of consumer affairs will act as a chairman. Official members and non-official members will be prescribed by the central government. Okay, the central government shall meet, sorry, the Central Consumer Protection Council shall meet at least once in a year. Okay, then how a aggrieved party file a complaint. There are some important terms according to Consumer Protection Act 1996. Who is consumer? One buys goods or hires services for some value, which means buyer or amount fully paid or amount partly paid, which means installment method, and who takes hire, okay, and who takes products and credit also become a consumer. When or under the circumstances the complaints can be filed? False by traders and manufacturers if goods are defective. Okay, within that period the complaint can be filed. The complaint must be filed within the 3 months of the purchase, and if something testing of goods is required, then within the 5 months. Okay, they have given minimum time period, that is 3 months. Okay, where the complaints can be filed, already we have discussed the value of the case, the compensation value of the case. Within the 20 lakhs we need to file the case in the district forum. When the compensation worth is more than 20 lakhs and not exceeded 1 crore, they should be filed case in national state commission. When the case value is exceeded 1 crore, they should file the case in the national commission. So who is not consumer then? The person who obtained goods for resale. The person who purchased in the intention to resell, that is not consumer. The person who uses goods without approval of the buyer, and that is not goods, not consumer. The person who obtained goods, hires or avails of any services without consideration. Consideration is very, very important. Without consideration, there will be no transaction in law. Okay, we have discussed in the previous classes, without consideration, the contract can be called as a naked contract. Okay, the consideration will be called as a soul of the contract. Without consideration, no consideration, no contract. Okay, next. Roles of consumer organizations. There are consumer organizations which are established to educate the consumers. In India, there are about 500 consumer organizations working in the field of consumer protection. The most popular are Consumer Guidance Society of India, which is established in Mumbai, Citizen Action Group, Mumbai, Consumer Education and Research Center, CERC, Ahmedabad, which means Consumer Education Research Center. Okay, Common Causes, New Delhi, Consumer Unity and Trust Society, CUTS, which is established in to educate the consumers. Okay, So these associations have some functions, which means bringing out brochures, generals about consumer awareness, spreading consumer awareness, collecting data of different products and testing them, collecting the data of the products and testing whether they are hazardous or not, whether they are useful or not. Filing suits or complaints on behalf of consumers. If any consumer is not able to go to the consumer courts that are trade dressel agencies, when the consumer is uneducated, these kind of organizations will come forward and help to the consumer to file case on behalf of aggrieved party. Okay, educating the consumers to help themselves, educating women regarding consumerism. So what is consumerism? Why it has been came into force? They need to educate the women. Motivating people to ask for the quality marks such as ISI mark, ISMA mark. Whether consumers are going to purchase the things, they should check whether the product is having ISI mark, Agri mark or not. Okay, so these are the important topics of Consumer Protection Act. I hope this will give you a good knowledge and consumer protection. Thank you so much for having patience. Thank you so much.